Hello mga kapamilya, we are here at Paul Boulangere at Patisserie in BGC and I am Kresh Ramos. I am the head of social media publishing for ABS-CBN Digital Media and I am filling in for Angela for a very special back-to-back chat sesh with not only one but two international athletes who will be our guests for today's Man Crush Monday episode. Again, Man Crush Monday is ABS-CBN Lifestyle's way of giving you guys a chance to get to know up-and-coming actors, influencers, singers, celebrities, while on a very personal level, while seeing them do something exciting and fun. And if you missed out on this episode, don't worry guys, because we will be uploading the full episode on our official website, that's lifestyle.abs-cbn.com, and you can follow us on our official accounts on Twitter and Instagram, that's at abs-cbn-lifestyle. And I know you guys are excited as much as I am, but while you're tuned in live, you can send us your questions as we go along, and you can drop us a line in the comment section as we bring you the Man Crush of the Week. And I'm very excited, and I'm having first date jitters as this is Man Crush Monday, and to introduce you to our first guest today. He is a multi-awarded swimmer from Team USA, competing in freestyle and medley events like FINO World, Pan Pacific Championship, Pan American Games, and of course the Summer Olympics. He's a contemporary of world swimming greats and fellow hotties including Michael Phelps, Ryan Lochte, and with a little bias here guys, just a tad bit, with Zac Efron, whom he is super friends with. This is his first time to be in the Philippines to endorse the local fashion brand, Bench. And as for the other reason why he loves the Philippines, this may have to do with a certain Filipina Victoria's Secret model whom I am a fan. I am crazy about her. So without further ado, let us all welcome and say hi to Connor Dwyer.
What's up,
hi,
guys?
Hi, Connor.
How's it going?
Welcome to the Philippines.
Thank you for that wonderful intro.
Yeah, how's your experience here in the Philippines so far?
It's fantastic. You know, we flew 18 hours from LA yesterday, so I've only been here 10 hours, but you know, walked, got some coffee today, checked out the Bench shop, and now we're here having a little one-on-one.
Right, and have you learned any other Filipino words so far? Because I know you know how to speak I love you in Filipino. Yes, the Filipina fans went gaga online when you posted that on Instagram. How about other words?
Kels is trying to teach me some, but you may have to help out with that. She's gonna teach me when we go, you know, out on the islands. But what's one I should learn right now?
Okay, to greet your Filipino fans who are online right now, can you say "Kamusta kayo"?
Kamusta kayo.
That's how are you.
How are you? I like it.
Yeah.
Mr. Kyle.
And to make your experience here more warm, I think, we are going to be asking you to do something, a very Filipino activity for us.
Got it. Let's
do
it.
So, kids, Filipino kids, usually like to do this. This is called the fortune teller flower game.
I think we do that in the States, too.
Really?
A little bit, yeah. We did that.
So, the mechanics is you have to choose two numbers, and then the second number has a designated challenge inside.
Got it.
So that's the twist. So I hope you're ready to do some fun challenges.
Let's have some fun.
But we also have questions online for you. The Filipino fans are ready for your arrival. So they sent us questions right now. So the first question is, hi Connor, love you. Would like to ask, what's the best part of Kelsey's personality for you? Of course, Filipinos are all fans of Kelsey.
I mean, who wouldn't be a fan of Kelsey?
Right.
I'm her biggest fan. So
I think I'm the biggest fan.
Okay, I don't know about that. But, you know, we met, we've been together almost a year now, and I'd have to say just how sweet and humble she is as a person through everything she's been through over the last year is, you know, she hasn't changed a bit, so I really appreciate and adore how sweet and kind she is to everyone.
And if Kelsey is tuned in right now, I love you, Kelsey. Sorry. This is supposed to be Man Crush, not Woman Crush.
Well, we should have Pablo here.
Yeah.
We should have our dog here.
I love
and then
Pablo, too. I follow his Instagram.
He's a cutie.
Yes, he's a cutie. Next question. Do you have a pre-competition diet? Can you share it to us?
Yeah, you know, I've kind of, at like the Olympics or wherever, I grew up in high school with my mom making me like oatmeal with peanut butter, bananas, strawberries, you know, throw some fruit in there. That's kind of always my prelims. Meal would be like oatmeal or something like that, and then some pasta. You got a carbo load when you're swimming all that mileage every day.
Really?
And then I like, you know, chicken teriyaki rice bowls are right up my alley. I love all sorts of food, but I don't go too crazy around meats changing on my diet. So, you know, pretty bland foods that I eat around competition time.
But on a normal day, if normal there is day, no competition, do you indulge yourself?
Oh, yeah. I mean, I had to put on like 25 pounds when I was in college training for my first Olympics. So I ate 6,000 to 8,000 calories a day.
Whoa.
Eating was like a full-time job.
Whoa.
Yeah. So I almost like got sick of eating how much. You know, you train 4 to 7 hours a day, swimming 16,000 meters and gym. So you're eating, you know, 6 meals a day.
Wow. What's your favorite food, like ever? You can eat it all day, every day.
All day, every day?
Yeah.
That's a lot. that's a lot. I have to say, you know, I really enjoy like sushi or rice bowls. But, you know, I'm from Chicago, so if I'm going to have a cheat meal, I'll have deep dish pizza. Have you had it?
No, I haven't tried
it. It's like
that.
A really thick, like, pie-like pizza.
Pie-like
it's what Chicago
pizza.
Is known for. Yeah, look it up.
Oh, my gosh. Here we just try out the thin crust.
Yeah, thin crust. Yeah, that's like New York style.
Oh, my gosh. Okay.
We'll have to bring over some deep dish pizza.
When
here.
I go to Chicago,
okay.
I'll definitely try that. But have you tried the Filipino food yet?
A little bit in Chicago and a little bit in New York, but I think we're gonna go all in. You know, we've been saving up for this trip, so I'm gonna eat everything that Kels tells me to eat.
So you're gonna go to a lot of famous places here in the Philippines.
Yes.
What's your first stop aside from
Manila, and then we go to Palawan.
Oh yes, Palawan.
Yeah, and then Boracay, and then finishing at Cloud Nine, which is
in Siargao.
Siargao.
Yeah.
Yes.
Perfect.
So I'm a surfer, so I think
you love
it's
it
only right that I had
you
to go
it
check
there.
It out. Yeah.
A lot of people go to Siargao now for the surfing, and it's perfect because it's summer. So
Kels and I have been cold for the last like 3 months, so we're excited to go to warm island.
Warm,
and her homeland to see it is pretty special.
And before we proceed to other questions from online, we have to play the game.
Okay, let's do it.
So okay, tell me a number.
5.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Another number.
3.
1, 2, 3. Okay, pick a number again.
In here.
Yeah.
7.
Okay, what is the challenge? Oh!
What is it?
You have to sing your favorite song.
No, Kelsey's the singer. I'm not the singer.
Let's pick another number. Okay, here.
All right, no.
Pick another number.
One more shot. So these are dares.
Yes.
Let's go with 4.
4. Okay. 4. You have to take a wacky selfie and post it on your Instagram.
A wacky selfie?
Wacky selfie. A lot of Filipinos do that here.
Do all you guys want to be in it?
We could. Sure.
Let's do it. So, come on.
Okay, but everyone has to be wacky. In a wacky pose.
What's a wacky pose?
Like...
Alright. Everyone in? There we go.
There. Wow. That's one there. Okay. And then let's do another one before we ask you questions again from the live fans. Okay. Pick a number.
2.
1, 2. Another number.
5.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then another number.
6.
Okay.
These are scary.
Dun 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 dun. Show the last message on your inbox.
On my inbox?
Yes.
I think it's from Ben, actually, because I posted I was in Manila. Let's see. Hold on.
Let us see the last message.
Okay, hold on. Actually, it's from Cal saying, wow. But then it's... He's the one that made it happen to get us over here.
Filipino fans are grateful to have you here. They've been requesting.
I'm walking in his show later. Are you guys going to come?
Yeah, we will.
Good.
The Lifestyle team are going to be there to support and
Bench
cheer you on.
Bench is going to put on a show, so it should be fun.
And a lot of the fans are posting on your comment section for a while now, telling, Connor, can you go here to the Philippines?
I will say Filipino fans, I think, are the best in the world from what I've seen.
Thank you.
With how nice and you know, supportive you guys are of what Kelsey does is pretty special.
That's right. And then, okay, next question. Who's the naughtiest? I think this is about your friends. Zach, Dylan, or Sean?
Naughtiest?
Naughtiest. Or you?
That's Sean, definitely. Sean, you know,
naughty.
Sean and Zach are, we're Pen Shop guys.
Yeah, I'm
repping, I think, the better brand over with Ben. So, you know, we kind of go back and forth with that. No, it's a rivalry, but they're great guys. I'd say Sean's probably gets in the most trouble.
Next question. Okay, can you do other accents than you have now? Other accents? Can you imitate
accents?
Yeah, like, I don't know, Sean's accent.
No, Georgia? I am from Georgia, Kennesaw, Georgia. You know, I can't do it. The southern accent's different. I went to Florida Gators. Is that okay?
You can do that a little. Yeah.
A little bit.
Next question, it's of course about Kelsey again. So how, what was your first impression of her, and what's your favorite workout routine with her?
Ooh. First impression, we met in Costa Rica, walked in, and you know, I was shook right off the bat, nervous to meet her. And what's the second part of it?
What's your favorite workout routine with her? I think
We do Pilates a lot. So she kind of helped introduce me to like Pilates, Studio MDR, Mega Reformer, and it's very hard, and we like to go to that together. She doesn't like to do as much cardio as I do. She's good in the weight room, she's good in Pilates, yoga, but when it comes to, you know, running, swimming, biking, she's more laid back than that.
Yeah, I think she posted that on her IG story saying that she doesn't like to do that much often. I tell you guys, I'm a fan. So I follow her and watch her daily.
Yeah,
yes.
Love it.
Okay, next question. What other sports did you take on before swimming?
Yeah, you know, from like 10 to 16, I wanted to play other sports with my brothers and cousins. You guys probably, do you have much hockey here?
No.
Yeah,
not
see,
much.
I had an ice rink in my backyard growing up because it was so cold for that many months.
Ice rink on your backyard?
Yeah, you just sit inside or you like go outside and play hockey. So I played, you know, hockey, basketball, water polo, baseball, but swimming was always, you know, my passion, and I think it chose me. I didn't choose it, so it's just kind of an element that I'm very comfortable in, is the water and swimming.
A lot of fans are inspired and idolizes you because of what you do and of your achievements so far. But for you personally, who's your idol? Who's the person you look up to the most?
For swimming, it'd have to be, you know, in college when I was at Iowa and I barely made it on the college team and walked on, I had a poster, he knows it now, but it was embarrassing, of Michael Phelps on my dorm room. And then fast forward, you know, 4 years later, we're somehow roommates and we're on, we're competing against each other to make the Olympic team, and then we're on the same relay. So, you know, I grew up idolizing Michael for what he did in Beijing and winning 8 golds, but, you know, then we became friends. I realized he's a normal guy, but he's not so normal in the pool. He's insane.
A monster. He's
crazy.
Yeah,
he's like unbeatable, but, he was definitely my idol in the swimming world.
But what was your first reaction when you found out, oh my gosh, Michael is my roommate and I'm competing against him? How was that? How did it feel?
Yeah, I'll never forget like the first time, you know, I was like 21 and we were at a random meet in Carolina, and Phelps is in lane one, I'm in lane two, and Lochte's in lane three. And I kind of came out of nowhere, but racing the two best guys in the world, I was like, okay, this is getting real now. And from 2008 trials, I was just there watching. And I'm like, my goal is to swim and compete in front of 13,000 people with fireworks in a stadium.
Right.
And, you know, at 2012 Olympics, again, it was myself, Lochte, and Phelps next to each other, all going toe-to-toe, touching each other out. So it was like almost a dream to be competing against guys I idolized, but I would say I outworked a lot of people to get to where I got.
You worked hard for it.
Exactly. Yeah. But it was really special to be on a team with guys I looked up to my whole career.
That must have been nerve-wracking.
Yeah. Well, actually, in 2012, we were in the ready room, and, you know, it's China here, France, Australia, us, England, a couple other teams, and Michael just lost the 200 fly for the first time in 10 years, and he comes in, he's like, Connor, you better get me a lead. And this was my first Olympics. I'm like 22, the best swimmer ever, just told me to get him a lead.
Just so told you that. So what?
I got him a lead.
What pressure.
Yeah, exactly.
But in the end, yeah, you succeeded.
Yes.
Okay, before any more questions, you have to pick a number.
All right, back to the game.
Back to the game.
What do we got over here? Seven?
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Another number.
Three.
Three. Okay, pick a number.
What do we got? Four again. Or is that the same one?
I think that's the same one. So
then we'll go with eight.
Okay. Show us your hidden talent, if you have a hidden talent. Show us your hidden talent.
Hidden talent?
Yeah.
Right now?
Mm-hmm.
I can't. I mean, I would say like surfing would be my hidden talent, but I can't show you how to do that.
Okay, then just promise us that you are going to post lots of videos when you're Cloud Nine.
Deal.
Okay. I'm going to be looking into
What's
that personally.
What's your hidden talent? Can you show us?
No, I can't show you.
Come on.
I am the host. I don't think I have a hidden talent. I write. Oh my God, I love writing and I love to write books. So probably that's my hidden talent.
I like that.
I can show you that right now.
Kelsey's is singing. You got to get Kelsey to sing more.
Oh my gosh.
She's got a fantastic voice.
Anything Kelsey does.
Karaoke,
it's fantastic
she's
for me.
Lights out. She's great.
Oh my God. Okay. And we are down to our last question from the fans. Wait, let's choose the best. Let's choose the best. Okay. This is about Kelsey again, but another adorable being that we love online and we met online. How do you and Kelsey take turns taking care of Pablo? He's with you guys in the gym, in the plane.
He flies. Yeah. He flies New York, LA. He's a little troublemaker, though. He's actually at a camp right now for 14 days.
Yeah,
you know,
I saw
learning
that. What kind of camp is that?
It's with like this private trainer that's gonna, you know, teach him a little discipline. because Kelsey and I are a little nice, so we let him get away with some things. So, you know, we switch off taking care of him, and if I'm not there, one of my brothers will help out. But he's the cutest thing ever.
And he is Instagram popular already.
I mean, you cannot walk him down the street in LA or New York without someone stopping you and wanting,
calling him Pablo.
Exactly. So he's a little legend himself. And he's at camp. Hopefully we get back and he can surf or I don't know, do sit, stay, lay down, a bunch of tricks is what we're hoping for.
Oh, he would have loved the Philippines.
We'll get him
hands
there.
Hands down.
We'll
so when there. You go back, hope you bring Pablo with you guys.
We will.
And
thank
do another
you.
Interview with Pablo alone.
Yes, deal.
With Pablo alone. Okay,
deal.
And last dare before we let you go. Okay, give us a number.
Two.
One, two. Another number.
Three.
One, two, three. Okay, pick one.
Six? Did we do six yet?
We didn't do six yet. I have to check. Yeah, we did, so...
Whatever. Oh, you can pick one.
Okay, I'll pick the hardest. okay. The fans will love this. Say mahal kita while looking at the camera the sexiest way possible. The sexiest way.
I don't know the sexiest way possible, but mahal kita. And thank you is...
Yeah.
Salamat.
Salamat. Salamat. Maraming salamat.
Salamat.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yay! Thank you,
Connor.
You
very much.
That's it. And we'll see you later. Oh, what?
Sorry.
Thank you. Thank you for doing the interview with us. And thank you, guys. Yes, and guys, thank you for watching and tuning in and for sending all of your questions. Again, if you miss out on this episode, you can watch it again over and over on our official website. That's lifestyle.abs-cbn.com. And you can always follow us on our official account on Instagram and Twitter at ABS-CBN Lifestyle. Thank you, guys. And we have another man crush later in a while. So, bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.